today. Follow Ken around has been the name of these videos. So we're at the National Tsunami Warning Center. What a treat I have for everybody today. And people don't think about it. National Weather Service. It's more than weather. We're water. We're space weather. We're tsunamis as well. And that's what we're going to talk about today. So, Summer, how you doing? So introduce yourself to everybody and tell everyone what you do here.
Hi, everybody. I'm Summer Ohlendorf. I'm the Science and Operations Officer here at the National Tsunami Warning Center. So I'm keeping an eye on all the data that comes into our center, making sure we're using the best science to look at it and figure out what to do. And I also keep our staff sharp and well-trained and ready to respond to any event we might have.
And I know you do a great job because in my time here over the last hour or so, super sharp folks, absolutely amazing to be able to talk to everybody here. So here's the deal. Give an earthquake. All right, so something happened. We've got something going on. So take me through the process. What happens? This could be in the middle of the night. You're on shift. It's not like you have days looking for a hurricane or a week, right? It's not like you're looking for a severe weather event 2-3 days ahead of time. This just happens, right, everybody? It just happens. Earthquakes just happen. So there's no notice. Right. What do you do? Something bad happens.
So if the earthquake is here, first of all, we're dropping, covering, and holding on during the shaking itself. But afterwards, we're responding and we're trying to figure out where the earthquake is, how big it is, and then what that means for the tsunami hazard. So we use these systems to look at the earthquake data. Our systems are set up so that we know, based on the earthquake information, pretty quickly exactly what that's going to mean as far as what alert areas we want to set up for any tsunamis. And so we want to make sure that we're confirming with our coastal emergency managers and the public that we get out the messages that we need to quickly and that those are received and understood.
Okay, so we've talked to the earthquake, and why are you so passionate? What brings you to work every day?
I love using science to actually help people. So this is my way of knowing about something right when it's happening and using those logic and reasoning skills to actually make decisions to help keep people safer.
That's amazing. How about that? Okay. All right. So we have an earthquake. We got work to do. So we're going to go this way. So we've got an earthquake. We're going to talk about how we're going to detect a tsunami. What are we going to use for tools? How are we going to do that? And who are we bringing in?
We bring in our scientists.
All right. So first of all, name and introduce yourself to everyone. And what do you do here?
Hi, Kara Sterling. I am a lead duty scientist here at the National Tsunami Warning Center. I spend a lot of my time working on improvements to the forecasting model and also coming up with new ways that we can provide impact decision support for our partners during tsunami events. So there's a lot of information. We get it really quick in the first 30 to 60 minutes and trying to condense that down into something that we can provide you to make decisions with.
So. And I don't have to tell you because you already know, right? Alarms and bells. Maybe Summer's yelling from across the room. I don't know what happened, but all of a sudden there's an earthquake.
Yes.
What are we doing?
We've got a big event. We want to know what the possible impacts are. One of the first things we look at are expected history and our early forecast. So we will actually take that event. You can see over here, we've modeled a 9.3, which is a really large earthquake off of Kodiak. Something like that would put our entire coastline from Aleutians, Alaska, all the way down to California, Mexico, in a warning. So that's a big event.
And there isn't one.
Yeah.
So those watching,
exercise. Calm
down. We're just exercising here. Okay.
You see a lot of red. It's not real.
Okay.
We can show kind of where the majority of the energy will be directed for something like this as well. And we're going out with a message, letting everyone know that we have issued a warning. I've pulled up one of the messages here. So we review that. We send it out, and it goes out across the lines, all sorts of ways people will get the message. But then we're forecasting. We're looking at water levels, coastal tide gauges, offshore deep pressure sensors. We're bringing that in real time, and we're adding it into our forecast. Anything that goes above 1 meter for an estimated wave height, you're going to be in a warning. So we're constantly looking at what we can see for coastal water levels and out in the deep ocean to see how big that tsunami is and how it's propagating. We do use two forecast models, a simple one over here called the Alaska Tsunami Forecast Model. And then over here we have SIFT. This model especially has some neat additional products. So with the SIFT forecast, not only can we see wave heights and the directionality, but we are also looking at expected flooding for a local area, as well as the time series. That time series in relation to the tides at that area, and also tsunami currents, where you might have hazardous harbors and where navigation will be difficult.
If you got a current, a boat might not be able to get away or be able to travel in the day of the situation. So amazing amount of science here. I'm going to ask the same question that I asked Summer. I mean, look at this, the science that you do, and you turn it to service, which saves lives. What brings you to work every day? What's your passion?
You know, I love that it's applied science and that I feel like I'm doing something that makes a difference and that I'm giving back. So
it's amazing. I just got goosebumps. So, we had earthquake, running models, looking at how much water, analyzing things, look at the energy propagation, looking at the water levels are going to be. Wait, we got to let people know. We got to let people know. So what products are issued? We're going to do that next. We're going to come right over here. So, first of all, introduce yourself and what do you do?
Hi, I'm Ben Heath. I'm a duty scientist here, so I stand watch and look out for earthquakes or any other activity that might indicate tsunamis.
So I'm an emergency manager somewhere. I'm the general public. I'm at home. All this analysis, amazing science has gone on. What products are issued? How do I know something bad's about to happen?
So if there was a big earthquake, we'd have four different kinds of alerts that we could put you into. The first one would be a warning. That means get to high ground immediately. You follow evacuation signage. This means we're expecting something, inundation of about 1 meter. We're expecting waves of about a meter or more. So that's something that is very impactful. We want you to act immediately. We could also put you in an advisory. That means stay out of the water, stay away from shore. We're expecting something in the 1 to 3 feet category. So it's something that could have impacts, but isn't massive impacts. Or massive waves. We also have a watch. That means prepare to take action. Tsunami is possible. It might be several hours away, but we want you to prepare now so you can act if you need to. So that's just a prepare stage. And then if it was a moderate-sized earthquake that we really don't think is going to produce a tsunami, we're going to put out an information statement. That might be, hey, I felt something. Is this something I should be worried about? This is a no tsunami is expected, but you might have felt that.
That's amazing. So really connecting the science to the service part of it. Same question as I've already asked. What brings you to work every day? What makes you so passionate about this here?
I really like making these decisions with limited information and then trying to talk people through those decisions and help them understand what I know in real time.
It's really important to meet everybody here because most of the time we don't think of tsunamis as part of what we do. It's a big part of our mission at the National Weather Service. And to think about this, I want to reiterate this once again. It's really important. You know, back at the Hurricane Center when I was there, I mean, we'd see it a week ahead of time, right? So we'd have some preparation time. I think that's important. Severe weather event, we've had quite a bout of tornadoes. We start looking at those outlooks 3-4 days a week ahead of time as well. This just happens. So it was really important to come here, introduce everybody to what's going on. Think about it from 0 to 100 miles an hour, just like that. Wait, they're faster than that. How fast do they go? Wait. How fast do they go?
They go airplane speed in the deep ocean.
Okay, just like that. So we're going from 0 to airplane speed, just like that type of thing. So I wanted to introduce to the amazing people at the National Tsunami Warning Center, an amazing bunch of scientists, and providing that service to save lives. And I think it's amazing that we really look at this and just realize they're 24/7 thinking about keeping you safe from tsunamis. So this has been Ken Graham Live right here in Palmer at the National Tsunami Warning Center. Thank you.